Awesome. Hello, I am Maulik Modibal. Awesome. So, I work for ThoughtWorks. I am a user interface developer. So, I was just spiking out the ideas about something that came in my mind before last month. So, I talked to my few of my friends that this idea makes sense or not. So, yeah, they told me it does make sense. You should try out. So I started spiking out. I called a couple of my JavaScript friends and they told me, okay, let's start building this thing if we can do that. So we started using Node.js, all those funky cutting edge stuff, and started building the thing. Let me tell you what the idea is actually. So here it is. So the thing is, it's actually we are targeting the users who are not front-end developer and all those things, who don't know CSS, who don't know HTML, and they wants to make a, or they wants to start any application, right? Like Twitter Bootstrap is the best tool for them right now. So it's one step ahead from Bootstrap. Let's see what it does and all. So we list down all the different styles of buttons here. Not only buttons, but there are so many other elements we are going to use, like combo boxes, breadcrumbs, radio buttons, blah, 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 all this stuff. So we have right now a repository for buttons, so I'll show you what actually we are doing here. So it's like, if you like this button, okay, so if you click it, you'll see the button here. If you need the code of the, you will just do that. You will have a CSS for this particular button and HTML for the button. So you can copy it and you can directly use it. So now people will ask me like how it's different from CSS deck and all those JS Fiddle and all those things. So it's different in which way? It's particularly organized. Like we are going to ask users what actually you are going to start with. Like first you will select the button, then you will select the color, then you will be able to explore all those things only. It's like filter by color, filter by particular. If you like Facebook CSS style button, you can search it directly from here. So it's like all those managed code, managed repository. So Pulak is helping me out to get this thing done. So we both are working right now. So it's an open source project. We are not going to charge or something like that. It's just for us, by us. It's like that.
So we can contribute code snippets?
Huh?
They can contribute code snippets here?
Yeah. They can. You can help me to build this out. You can help me buy codes and all those things. So right now we don't have facility to, we are going to do this now. That is, if you have GitHub account, just log in and paste your snippet here. Right now only we can do that by this screen. Right now only we can, but we are adding functionality next week.
Actually, one of the cool things you could do is, since you said like people might search like Facebook button, what you could do is you can ask people to give a URL, open it in an iframe, let people click on a button and say, okay, what is stuff?
Awesome idea, makes sense.
Yeah.
Thanks.
I mean, because for most people, they already have something in mind, and
yeah.
So it could be the starting base.
Yeah, makes sense. Thanks.
What about multiple browser support? The CSS you're providing is
We provide all the vendor prefixes. So probably it has right now.
So are you targeting minimum HTML file or?
Yes. Right now we are going to Happy Path. All the edge cases will come. See.
And would you have your mobile styles also? Mm-hmm. Your mobile styles also?
Another edge case. So we are just trying like. Like I'm talking to many people about this idea, whether it's nice, because it's like my intentional is to learn all these things and to build it's not like so it's an open source pure.
You should like take inspiration from Dribbble. Dribbble has become this place where people go, so it could become the same sort of UX and same sort of thing.
Initially, I struggled a lot to explain how it is different from Bootstrap actually. So people accept it and it makes sense and all those things. Any other?
Do you provide any JavaScript with this, like if you have some specific tech?
Yeah, that's but there are lots of stuff available. My initial is HTML and CSS for non-UI guys. This is the first personas that I'm targeting right now.
And is it possible to so these are predefined buttons, right? It's not like you're generating them. Like if you ask for a different color than what you have.
Yeah, actually I'm going to do that, all those sliders to change the colors and all those things. But slowly, there are lots of tools available for individual functionalities. I'm slowly putting in a one.
When did you start working on it?
Sorry?
When did you start working on it?
Last month only. So it's just a 1 month effort.
That's pretty good for us.
Malik, are you also planning to do something about people actually being able to do a layout or something?
Good idea, but we can do that, but first let's have a repository for everything, then we'll do that as well. So it's an ongoing stuff.
Basically, we are just stabilizing the so the idea is like here, generally as a UI, we do lots of copy-pasting, to be honest. We don't go and write. So even doing copy-pasting, we stumble. View source, get the CSS or JS, we do it. So here the main focus is our elements will giving you styles or later on JS as we are speaking about in a nice easier way that you can just take it and paste it. No other thing. And the idea you said like trying out if you have green color and you are thinking of red color gradient. So this editor is just opened right now, just click on that. Like this editor, here we will change it. Click on the button below to see the result that the cursor is. Click on that and the result you will see here. So here you edit it, you see the result. If you are happy with it, you can copy paste or we can have a feature like download this type.
Yeah.
So it will download as a zip file and you can do it.
So the next feature we are working on right now is if you like this button, if you like this combo box, you will not have to go to individually to download everything. We are providing a button here that will download the entire theme for you for this particular thing. So you can directly use it.
You should also
Give
support for sales and less.
Awesome.
That support, I believe, suppose if you are an ordinary user, your main intention is to get the style. How you are implementing less as that's a developer job. So we can implement it like we have an editor here where you can create a button. This is a dynamic created button. So where there if you use less as that's up to the developer. But if you are an end user to get the styles, even lookout is not the less or styles, it's the style of it. So first, what we think for a novice user, basic users, you get the styles, you use it. Layers as is for experienced people, then we can.
And this tool is not for experienced
people. It depends.
No, experienced people in the sense it will help you reduce your development time. Development time is important. Why we copy paste?
Okay, first let me explain you. Like first you got a project. Okay, you don't know which style and all those things. Select. Come here. Like your logo color is orange, right? Orange buttons, you get it, select button, download the theme, and you are done with your HTML elements. That's it. We don't have to take care of.
Bootstrap supports less.
I'm not saying we can't do, we can do, but we'll have to start from somewhere, right? So.
Twitter Bootstrap supports less because it's a framework is on less. Twitter Bootstrap. But here we are not giving someone a framework. We are not giving someone download this framework and start as a replacement of some other framework. Here the objective is not like that. Here the objective is to give certain styles, certain JavaScript which you will plug and
so this is a GitHub URL if you want. the coding stuff sucks right now, so forget it. So we are just improving it. We are going agile, pure. So that's it.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Very cool.